So I know as a younger adult, it sometimes seems like it's always something near about to get into.
Right.
And although I say younger, I really don't think it's an age level. So sometimes you can be minding your own business, determined to do good, living your best life. And there's somebody shooting that shot, somebody placed it for you. And this is in your best interest to be involved with.
Right.
And to be honest, sometimes we set up the evil. We purposefully create an atmosphere. But it is important to run from evil, especially after giving God your yes. There's great comfort in living a life or striving with your best efforts to live a life where you feel God will hear your prayers and honor your yes. It's hard to dwell long and partake in evil deeds and still pray and expect God to honor your yes. And hear your prayers.
All right.
Every day, put forth the effort to run from evil. 2 Timothy 2:22 encourages us to flee. Fleeing, just like surrendering, is an action word. It is of human nature and therefore natural for us to bend towards sin and sinful tendencies. But we must flee and follow God's plan. How else can you give God your yes? Put God first in your life. This could have easily been mentioned as number one. Matthew 6:33 says, but seek ye first the kingdom of God. And all this righteousness, and all these things should be added unto you. It's pretty self-explanatory. Commit yourself to God, and he will grant you the desires of your heart. How else can you give God your yes? Check yourself by God's word. Truth comes from God and his word. And giving God our yes, we need to honestly check ourselves. No one knows you like you. If we are going to fully and truly trust God, we need to use God's scripture, God's review, God's great care and concern for our very soul. It should be a guiding light drawing us closer to him. Proverbs 3:11-13 makes clear it is a blessing to be made better by Jesus. How else can you give God your yes? Listen to the Holy Spirit. Sometimes checking yourself just isn't enough. Your mind can make excuses and justify wrong actions, but Jesus remedied this by sending his Holy Spirit. And it has one job to do. John 14:26 confirmed that the Holy Spirit will teach you all things. You know, a couple of weeks back, we were told to check out Holy Ghost. The Holy Spirit would guide you. We do not have to face life challenges alone. The Holy Spirit will lead us into all truth. And finally, my favorite stuff, we can give God our yes by resting in God's love. This is the benefit of giving and trusting God with your yes. The psalm said there is peace in yes. And what great peace it is. Every day we face a difficult world where we understand that if we understand that we are the children of God, our Father is a good Father. He cares for his children. Our entire perspective and outlook on life and life challenges change. We become advocates for ourselves because we know the judge. Setbacks aren't failures. It's an opportunity to grow in God. Sickness isn't the end. It's an opportunity for God to show himself. No money isn't depressing. It's an opportunity for God to stretch it down and show up. Give him our whole yes. And why not? He is faithful. He is merciful. He is always with us. Now, even though this is still easier said than done, we know we must trust God, but personally for me, the challenge wasn't trusting God. I know I serve a great God. For me, it's that lingering, what if? What if I do give God my yes and still things go south? As Christians, believers in Christ, we must know that even with our best effort, stuff still will go wrong.
Yeah.
I think the perfect illustration of this, and personally my favorite Bible story, is my three friends, because they're my friends. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
All right. Yes, yes.
We all know the story of the Hebrew boys, but I think we often overlook a very important fundamental and foundational principle of our testimony. Daniel 3 tells of how they lived a righteous life, and yet something went wrong.
Yeah.
They found themselves in trouble. However, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego gave God their yes.
Yes.
They trusted him, and they were fully persuaded. Nothing could make them bow down to King Nebuchadnezzar's statue. Not threats, not consequences, not punishment, not death. But most importantly, not only were they obedient to God's command, they were equally persuaded of the promise of God.
Yeah.
We must get the attitude and disposition of the three Hebrew boys if we are truly to give God our yes and trust him with it. So just a slight recap. So King Nebuchadnezzar made a decree that all the people of his province